मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज द 16th पार्ट ऑफ सर्किल्स। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन अबाउट इनवर्स पॉइंट्स एंड प्रॉब्लम्स बेस्ड ऑन इनवर्स पॉइंट्स। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वांट राइट द डेफिनेशन ऑफ इनवर्स पॉइंट्स। ओके स्टूडेंट्स, द डेफिनेशन इज गिवन एज इनवर्स पॉइंट्स विद रेस्पेक्ट टू ए सर्किल। लेट सी बी ए सेंटर एंड आर बी द रेडियस ऑफ ए सर्किल विच इज कॉल्ड एस इक्वल टू जीरो। The points P and Q are said to be inverse points with respect to the circle if those two points should satisfy three conditions. First condition, C comma P comma Q are collinear. Second condition, P and Q are same side of the C. Third condition, CP into CQ is equal to R square. R stand for radius of the given circle. Okay, observe here. This is the circle. Center of the circle. Now we want to locate the points on the same plane which are inverse. According to the concept, for example, all the three should be collinear. C, P, Q are collinear. And P and Q are same side of C. Same side of C, either this side or this side. Just I will take right hand side. Okay, so this is say P and somewhere say Q. Okay, so C, P, Q are collinear. And P, comma Q are same side of C. And CP into CQ is equal to R square. CP into CQ. This length CP into CQ should be equal to radius square. Then you can say that those two points are said to be inverse point with respect to the circle. Okay. This is the definition. This is the location. But if a circle is given, okay, how to locate inverse points with respect to that circle? I will explain working rule or how to construct inverse points on a plane. That is better. How to construct inverse point on a plane when circular equation is given. First of all, this is a circle. This is center. Take any point on the same plane. Take any point P on the same plane. Okay. Other than center. Same plane. Maybe interior or exterior, your wish. Okay. Step one. Take a point P on the same plane. Okay, my condition is C not equal to P. Okay, somewhere here P. Next step, join CP and extend and produce. So on this produced line only Q will be, according to the definition CP, Q are collinear, no? But I want to identify now. P is chosen, no? P is chosen. C is fixed here. C is fixed. P is variable point. I took P is here. I can take outside also. Just I took inside P. Now I want to identify Q under these two conditions. Already C, P, Q are collinear. Okay, the Q should be on the line only. Now I want to identify the line so that PQ are same side and CP into CQ is equal to R square. That is important. My working rule is, see here, third one, draw a line perpendicular to CP through P. This is interesting step. Through P we need draw a line which is perpendicular to this. Let it meet circle at A and B. Say this is A, say this is B. Now important observation. So already you know that in a circle, this is chord, the center of the circle. From center, if you draw perpendicular and a chord, it will bisect it. Automatically what happened in here? CP is perpendicular to AB. Here AB is chord. So automatically what I can say? AP equal to PB only. So this implies AP equal to PB, or another word, second is that CP is a perpendicular bisector of AB. Now actually I want to locate the point Q on extended CP. The fourth step, draw tangents to circle at A and B. Let they meet at Q on produced CP. This is important word. So through Q, through A, we need to draw tangent. Through B also you draw tangent. How can you say that they meet it on extended CP? That is important. So what is draw tangents to the circle at A and B? Let they meet Q on the produced CP. Why I am saying on produced CP? Observe here. These two triangles are congruent triangles because AP equal to BP only. Draw tangents from A and B, automatically they meet on extended CP only. So Q located. Now fifth step. So Q is the location of inverse of P with respect to S equal to 0. So I identified Q. Now I'm saying Q and P are inverse points, but you need to prove. We need to prove. Condition 1, C, P, Q are collinear. Okay, on the straight line only. Condition number 2, P and Q are same side of C. Okay, completed. Third one should prove, no? CP into CQ should be equal to R square. If that is true, then I can say that P and Q are the locations of inverse point of this circle. Okay, so proof. First one, CP, Q are collinear. Second one, P, Q are same side of C. Now I want to put that CP into CQ is equal to R square. To that, join CA. Tangent, no? Radius, automatically perpendicular. Join this, automatically perpendicular. Observe, this triangle and bigger right triangle are similar. Angle C is common, so I will write here. So this triangle CPA triangle and this CAQ triangle, here 90, here 90, C common. From AA similarity, the two triangles are similar. Triangle CPA similar to triangle CAQ, in bracket AA similarity. If two triangles are similar, their corresponding parts are in proportion. CP by CA equal to CA by CQ. What is this Q, Nana? CA square equal to CP into CQ. CA square radius square only, R square. Therefore, CP into CQ equal to R square. Now, I can say that P, Q are inverse points. Now, in this way, you can locate inverse points on the plane. Therefore, P, Q are inverse points with respect to S equal to 0. Okay, students, in this way, you can locate the inverse points on the plane. But here, important note, observe here, very important. X square plus Y square minus 3 equal to 0 is a circular equation. And 4 comma 5 is a point on the same plane. We can locate 4 comma 5 is on the circle or inside the circle or outside the circle by using the concept of power of point. By using concept of power of point, you can say that point is outside. See, S double 1 greater than 0. Okay, observe here. This is circular equation. The point is 4 comma 5 outside. Now I want to find the equation of chord of contact. First of all, I want to define what is the chord of contact. You know the definition of chord of contact. From here, we need to draw two tangents. They meet at A and B. Join AB. So this is the chord of contact. You can find the equation of chord of contact. That is S1 equal to 0. XX1 plus YY1 minus 3 equal to 0. 4X plus 5Y minus 3 equal to 0. Important note. 4X plus 5Y minus 3 equal to 0 represent a unique straight line on the coordinate plane. Unique straight line. 4x plus 5y minus 3 equals 0 represent a unique straight line on the coordinate plane. Why I'm repeating? Observe here. Okay, this is one of the problem. So now the question is, find the polar of 4,5 with respect to the circle. Polar. Point is outside. Now you want recall the definition of a polar. From this point, we need to draw infinitely many secants. At extremities of the secants, we need to draw line tangents. The point of intersection of those tangents, only the polar. Okay. So this is one line. Like that. We get one straight line. Straight line. This is equation of a polar. Find the equation of the polar. Already you know that. That also S1 equals 0 only. Same equation we will get. So previously what I told, 4x plus 5y minus 3 equals 0 represent unique straight line on the coordinate plane. Means what happened here? Equation of the chord of contact and equation of the polar same. What is the meaning of this? If 4,5 is outside the circle. Okay. Next, the equation of the polar and the equation of chord of contact are same. Means that this is circle is given, here a point is given. So here are two tangents are drawn. So point of tangent is joined. So this is called chord of contact of this point with respect to the circle. Now I can call this is the polar of this point with the circle. Same. Same. Okay. If P is taken as inside, there is a meaning of chord of contact. There is a definition of chord of contact here. Through the P, you need to draw tangents. Okay. So there is no meaning of chord of contact. There is a meaning of polar. So, this is become the polar equal. That is S1 equal to 0. Here there is no meaning of chord of contact. But here chord of contact and polar are same. So they are representing 4x plus 5y minus 3 equal to 0 only, no? One more thing. If P is taken on the circle, through P draw tangent. This only the tangent. This only the polar. This only the chord of contact. So what I'm saying here, from Q, listen here, from Q, two tangents are drawn. So AB is actually chord of contact. Now I can call AB is the polar of Q. What is the wrong? Okay, I can call AB is the polar of Q. Now some observations we will get. Now I can say that if P and Q are inverse points, so P lie on the polar of Q. Understood? One more important thing. P is nothing but the foot of the perpendicular drawn from center to polar of Q. Two important observations. One observation is the P and Q are inverse points. This P lie on the polar of Q. And also P is nothing but foot of perpendicular drawn from center of the circle to polar of Q. These two important for us. So more observations. Important. Listen. Okay. So here P and Q are inverse points. So what I can say, this is the polar of P. Sorry. This is the polar of Q. P is on polar of Q. What the definition of polar? Actually, this is a circle. P is here, same P, same C, leave it. Same P, same. Now I want to find the equation of polar of P. Or I want to locate the polar of P. So what should do? We need to draw number of secants, their point of tangents is, you need to know tangents to extremities points of that secants, somewhere they meet, so that only the polar. Understood? What are the meaning of that? From those, from P, you need to draw secants. No, this is one of the secant. Through extremity of the secant, two tangents are drawn. They are meeting at Q. What is the meaning of this? Q is lies on the polar of P. Already, P lies on the polar of Q proved. Now, by after this explanation, we can conclude that Q lies on the polar of P. Three important conclusions we got. First conclusion is P and Q are inverse points. P lie on the polar of Q. Q lie on the polar of P. Okay. Next one is P is nothing but foot of perpendicular drawn from center to circle on polar of Q. By using this only, you can solve so many problems. So, what I explained, I will write here. And important observations. What I am doing here, I am explaining the concept of inverse point by using plane, just a general plane. I am not using coordinate plane, general plane I am explaining. So that is important. Observation, first one. If P, Q are inverse points, then polar of P with respect to S equal 0 passes through Q and vice versa. What is the meaning of and vice versa? Polar of P passing through Q and polar of Q will passing through. Polar of P with respect to S equal 0 passes through Q. Polar of Q will pass through P. That is the meaning of vice versa. Second one, that is, So, P, Q are conjugate points. Polar of P passes through Q and polar of Q passes through P. What is the meaning of that? They are conjugate points. No? If P and Q are inverse, then automatically they are conjugate points. But don't think that converse is true. Converse may or may not be true. Okay, if P, Q are conjugate points, okay, third one, what is P is the, so here may be Q, here may be P, that is different, just I took P is inside, no? So if P is the foot of perpendicular drawn from center of circle to polar of Q. This is important. By using third observation, you can solve the problems. If circular equation is given and one point is given, we want to find its inverse. Just by using this concept only, you can find the another point. That's why P is the foot of perpendicular drawn from center of the circle to the polar of Q. Okay, fourth one. If P is on Q, P is on circle, what happened? P is inside, no, here. If P is inside, Q is outside, obviously. On our diagram, P is inside, Q is outside. So we'll discuss. If P is on the circle, then what happened? Observe here. So here, CP into CQ equal to R square only. Proved. If P is on the circle, no, what is the meaning of CP? CP also R only. R into CQ is equal to R square. When R can cancel, CQ is equal to R. Means what happened? C and P and Q are coincident one another. If P is on circle, then P and Q coincide. Okay. Fifth one. If P is inside, then Q must outside the circle. Okay, P is inside means what? Nana CP less than R. CP less than R. Okay, P is inside. What I'm saying? Q is outside. If P is inside, then CP less than R by the definition, power of point definition. So already you know that CP into CQ is equal to R square only. So here you can say that CQ is greater than R. Understood? CP less than R. Automatically, what I'm done here? CQ is greater than R. CQ is greater than R means Q is outside the circle only. That's why if P is inside, then Q must outside the circle. Nana, these are the important observations. By using these observations, this concept only, you can solve the problems on based on inverse points. Okay, students, just now I explained the concept of inverse points, but here one theorem is given, important theorem. So the theorem also saying same what I explained, but analytically you want to prove. Okay, see here what this theorem saying, that C is the center and R is the radius of a circle, x square plus y square plus r square. They took just basic circle. Yeah, two points P and Q are inverse points if and only if Q is the if and only if, this is important. Okay, Q is the point of intersection of polar of P and the line joining C and P. Okay, so if and only if means what? If these two are inverse point, this happens, or this happens, then these two becomes inverse points. Both you should prove now. Okay, first of all I want a rough sketch for that. This is center, somewhere here P, somewhere here Q. First of all, I am taking first case. What is my first case? P comma Q are inverse points. If P and Q are inverse point, then this happens. Q is the point of intersection of the polar of P and the line joining a point C and P. Okay, so already C and P are joined. This is Q. Now you want to show that polar of P will pass through Q. Okay, this is part one. Part A, you can say. Part A means P and Q are taken as inverse points. Let P comma Q are inverse points with respect to S equal to 0. S stand for x square plus y square equal to r square here. Okay. C automatically 0 comma 0. P is taken as x1, y1. This is taken x1, y1. This is 0 comma 0. This is taken as x2, y2. So Q is taken as x2 comma y2. Okay. So what is our observation here? What is our assumption? P and Q are inverse points. Automatically C comma P comma Q are collinear. Okay. And P and Q are same side of the C. Okay. And CP into CQ is equal to R square. By using those three conditions, you want to prove that Q is the point of intersection of polar of P and the line joining C and P. Okay. Okay. First of all, C comma P comma Q are collinear. Okay. So what is the area of the triangle formed by those three points become zero? Rough 0, 0, x1, y1, x2, y2, 0, 0. Means what is the meaning of that? X1, y2 minus x2, y1 equal to 0. This is one of the result. Next, what is given on here? CP into CQ is equal to R square. CP means distance from C to P. That is root over x1 square plus y1 square. CQ means what, Nana? Root over x2 square plus y2 square equal to R square. Just I am squaring x1 square plus y1 square into x2 square plus y2 square equal to r power 4. Understood? What is our intention? Q is the point of intersection of polar of P and the line joining C and P. Okay. Already this is straight line, no? So it is enough to prove that Q is lie on the polar of P. That's all. Means, these two points satisfy the condition of conjugate points. S12 equal to 0. My intention is I want to put that S12 equal to 0. Then I can say that Q is lie on the polar of P. Already Q is an extended CP only. Okay, so it is enough to put that S12 equal to 0. Or it is enough to put that P and Q are conjugate points. Okay, now I want multiply x1 square x2 square plus y1 square y2 square plus x1 square y2 square plus x2 square y1 square equal to R4. Okay, students. So now I want to simplify this. Now I want to use this result. x1 y2 minus x2 y1 value 0. No, x1 y2. x1 square y2 square a minus b 0, here a square plus b square is there. I want a minus b whole square. I want a square plus b square. If minus 2ab is there, I can write a minus b whole square. Minus 2ab I want, that's why I want add and subtract 2ab there. So x1 square x2 square plus y1 square y2 square plus x1 square y2 square plus x2 square y1 square. Now, minus 2x1 x2 y1 y2 plus 2x1 x2 y1 y2 equal to R4. Just I add and subtract. Observe these two. Combine these three terms with this. x1 square x2 square plus y1 square y2 square, and this you write first. Plus 2. x1 x2 y1 y2 plus a square plus b square minus 2ab a minus b whole square x1 y2 minus x2 y1 whole square equal to R4. So this is also a square plus b square minus 2ab form only. This one also x1 x2 plus y1 y2 whole square plus 0 square. I can say that already x1 y2 minus x2 y2 0, no, 0 square equal to R4 from 1. Now interesting step for the problem. Yeah, what happened here? x1 x2 plus y1 y2 equal to plus r minus r square. But I want to show that x1 x2 plus y1 y2 equal r square. I don't want a minus. I will show you. Wait, see here. This is a circle. Center of the circle is C0, 0. Here P and Q are the inverse point, no? Means P and Q are the same side of C only. For example, here PQ. This is X1, Y1. This is X2, Y2. So same side means what happened, Nana, here? X1 and X2 positive. Y1, Y2 positive. X1 and X2 positive. Y1 and Y2 positive. Their addition positive. Okay. Or they are this side, for example. Okay. X1, X2 negative, Y1, Y2 negative, X1 negative, X2 negative, product positive, Y1 negative, Y2 positive, product positive. Okay, that's what I can say. This is positive, total positive. For example, you can take like this. Here you can take here P, here Q. Okay, here what happened, Anna? Y1, Y2 positive, X1, X2 negative, this positive, this product positive, total positive. Means whatever may be Q. Here, P here and Q here, or P here and Q here. So what will you get, Nana? This product positive, this product positive. That's why total I can take positive. Therefore, x1 x2 plus y1 y2 equal to r square. Okay. So what is this x1 x2 plus y1 y2 minus r square equal to 0? What is s12? No, s12 equal to 0. With respect to the two points P x1 y1 Q x2 y2, if s12 equals 0 means what is the meaning of that? P and Q are conjugate points. Therefore, P, Q are conjugate points. By the definition of conjugate points, P and Q are conjugate points. Actually, what do you want to prove? Q will pass through polar of P. R. Q is the point of intersection of polar of P and the line joining the CP. Already that is on the extended point only. That's why it is enough to prove that Q is on polar of P. Just now I proved P and Q are conjugate points. What is the meaning of that? Therefore, Q is on polar of P. First part completed. So part 1, P and Q are taken as inverse point, you got this result. Part 2, inverse point, if and only if. Okay, so taking Q is on the point of intersection of polar of P and the line joining C and Q, we want to prove that P and Q are inverse points. That is part 2, or part B. Q is the point of intersection of polar of P and line joining C and P. What is the meaning of this? That is P comma C comma P comma Q are collinear. Okay, just now you want to do that. CP into CQ is equal to R square. CP into CQ is equal to R square. Okay. Okay. CP is equal distance from C0, 0 to polar. Distance is perpendicular distance. Distance from C0, 0 to polar of Q. Okay, first of all, I want to find polar of Q. What is polar of Q? Polar of Q is xx2 plus yy2 minus r square equal to 0 only. Distance formula, 0 comma 0 and this is xx2 plus yy2 minus r square. CP equal to, formula is mod ax1 plus by1 plus c by root over a square plus b square. 0, 0, mod of minus r square by root over x2 square plus, y2 square. So, CP equal to r square by root over x2 square plus y2 square means distance from Q to C. That is CQ. Therefore, CP into CQ is equal to r square. Means, I proved. Students, two example problems so based on inverse concept. Find the inverse point of this with respect to this circle and find the inverse of 1 comma 2 with respect to this circle. Here also we have several formulae to find the inverse for basic circle, for general circle. My sincere advice, please, no need to memorize all those formulae. By using basic formulae, you can find the solutions for such problems. Okay, see first one. We want to find the inverse of this point. Say this is P, we want to find Q. Or this is Q, you want to find P. You don't know the position. No? You can find by using power of point, you can say what is the position of the point. So you don't want position of the point. Directly you want to find its inverse. Say this is P, you want to find Q. Understood? What already explained, no? This is Q. P is nothing but foot of perpendicular drawn from center to polar of this point. Okay, by using that concept you can find. First of all, I want to find polar of 2 comma 3 with respect to the circle. Polar of 2 comma 3 with respect to x square plus y square minus 10 equal to 0. Now I want direct right direction of xx1 plus yy1 minus 10 equal to 0, that is 2x plus 3y minus 10 equal to 0. What is center of this circle? 0 comma 0. So, from 0 comma 0 to, we want foot of what is this? 2x plus 3y minus 10 equal to 0. Foot. Already have the formula finding foot. That is basic formula. You should remember. Okay, what is the basic formula for finding foot? This mark is not working. Okay, alright. Yeah, observe here. Nana. This is x1, y1. This is ax plus by plus c equal to 0. H comma k is the foot. Direct formula. H minus x1 by a equal to k minus y1 by b equal to minus times of ax1 plus by1 plus c by a square plus b square. Don't remember like root. Root is not correct. A square plus b square. Using this basic formula, you can find none. Okay. So this is h comma k. h minus 0, I will write here h minus 0 by 2 equal to k minus 0 by 3 equal to minus times of 0, 0 minus 10 by a square 4 plus b square 9. Okay, directly this 10 by 13, 10 by 13, 10 by 20 by 13. So directly I want to write h comma k equal to, here see, 10 by 13, 20 by 13, comma, here what happened, na? So 30 by 13, see, simply you can complete it. Na? So this is the inverse of 2 comma 3, you need to write conclusion, therefore inverse of 2 comma 3 with respect to x square plus y square equal to 10 is 20 by 13 comma 30 by 13. Okay, now I want to complete second problem. Again, same nana. We want to find the polar equation of this point with respect to the circle. Polar of 1 comma 2 with respect to x square plus y square minus 4x minus 6y plus 9 equal to 0. I already explained how to write S1, xx1 plus yy1. Okay, 2x you want, 2x minus 2 into 2x, 2 times of x plus x1 minus 3 times of y plus y1 plus 9 equal to 0. Substitutions, x plus 2y. Okay, minus 2 times of x plus 1 minus 3 times of y plus 2 plus 9 equal to 0. Or x plus 2y minus 2x minus 2 minus 3y minus 6 plus 9 equal to 0. So here minus x minus y. Okay, here 6 2 7 plus 2 equal to 0. Observe here minus 6 2 minus 8. Oh no, minus 6 minus 2 8 no 1. So what happened? Anna? X plus y minus 1 equal to 0 is the equation of the polar. Direct x plus y minus 1 equal to 0, center of the circle, where is that center of the circle, that is 2 comma 3, center of 2 comma 3. Now I want to find its foot, that is nothing but inverse of the that point. So h minus 2 by 1 equal to k minus 3 by 1 equal to minus times of 2 plus 3 minus 1 by a square 1 plus b square 1. Now I want to simplify this. What happened here? H minus 2 by 1 equal to k minus 3 by 1 equal to 3 plus 2, 5 minus 1, 4, minus 4, minus 4 by 2, minus 2. So that directly I can say that h equal to 0. And k equal to minus 1. Therefore, inverse of 1 comma 2 is 0 comma minus 1. Sorry, 0 comma minus 1, 0 comma 1. Minus transfer plus 1 only. No, sorry, 0 comma 1.